In this video, we will discuss the reasons for small firms. We'll focus on the reasons they exist and what may influence them to do so. First, we need to think about why small firms exist, because they do exist throughout all economies. They tend to have unique capabilities that are difficult for large firms to replicate. We'll look at these in more detail later. Sometimes small firms can supply services and goods to larger firms. It's also important to remember that large firms have to start somewhere. Even companies like Facebook were small at first. Let's take a closer look at some of the reasons firms remain small. It can simply be a case of the owner's objective. In many instances, the owner of a small business may not wish to expand their operations. Some people operate small shops to generate enough profit and income to sustain their lifestyle, and they may not desire the additional stress and challenges of growing their business. Consider this image. It represents a small corner shop which serves a local community. The owners may be satisfied with the income it provides and receive some enjoyment from serving their customers. It may not be appealing to them to expand their business, even if it would increase their profits and income. Another reason firms remain small is due to the lack of access to finance. They simply may not have sufficient financial resources to expand their business. If you've ever watched Dragon's Den or The Shark Tank, you'll see that entrepreneurs with great ideas and thriving businesses sometimes have insufficient finances to grow their businesses. Perhaps if they are successful in raising money, they can grow their business. For some firms, they operate in a niche market, which is a unique market segment. The image here is something those of us born in the 80s are familiar with. You'd struggle to find someone who still uses this. However, there is a small minority of people who use them, and thus an even smaller group of people who can repair them. Since most video viewers use streaming services or digital discs, the market is limited in its size. In some markets, consumers need personalized service, and this is often something that small firms can do very well. For example, a couple getting married may want a DJ who can play music that meets their specific needs. They may also require other entertainment and equipment that evening, and dealing directly with the DJ for everything can be a big help. The DJ will likely have a limited number of clients and can therefore focus greater attention on the couple. If you're a fan of Breaking Bad and the spin-off Better Call Saul, you'll remember how Kim Wexler leaves a larger firm to start her own practice. As part of her pitch in competition against a larger firm, she says that she can dedicate all of her energy to the one client, which is something the larger firm cannot offer. This is an excellent example of offering personalized service and support to a client. Smaller firms are not as restricted by the administration and bureaucratic procedures that limit the flexibility of larger firms. Therefore, they can respond more quickly to changes in customer tastes and preferences. A large business would typically take a longer time to make a significant decision due to the layers of management and people involved in the process. For example, changing the menu at a small local restaurant would be an easier and quicker process than it would be for a McDonald's franchisee looking to adapt their menu to the local population. In some instances, sellers face limited demand. This could be due to the fact that they are one of many suppliers in a market, or that the market may be quite small. For example, I live in Beijing along with many other expats from various different countries. If someone wanted to start a company doing Hindi translation, they may find the market to be relatively limited. This would be even more so the case for Urdu translation. You should have a deeper understanding of why small firms exist, and if you have examples of your own you'd like to ask about, write them in the comments box below. If you have any questions in the meantime, you can leave them in the comments or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.